graphics and visualization is subject, subject code 18CS62. So we are into OBE, outcome based education. So we are promising the students the 5 outcomes. So before going to program course outcomes, so what is this computer graphics subject is? Computer graphics and visualization. So we are into the era of digital, right? So everything, whatever we see through internet or through mobile, through desktop, or wherever we observe, so everything is made up of images, or I can say it's a digital world. So everything is in the form of digital or images. So we use social media like Facebook, Instagram. Everywhere we find so many images per second or per minute, correct? So, but basically as a computer science student, you should be curious about how these images are generated. I am not teaching here digital image processing, but here I am teaching you how we can generate a graphic elements using computer. Okay. So let us understand what is a computer graphics is, first of all. What is computer graphics? We have three words: computer, graphics and visualization. We know that computer is an electronic device which accepts some input, which processes the data and which gives some output. It's a very simple definition, right? Computer is an electronic device, so it will make a task easier. So we'll see what is the proper definition. I got some definition from Wikipedia. A computer is a machine that can be programmed to carry out sequence of arithmetic or logical operations automatically. It's a machine which performs some tasks automatically by doing some arithmetic and logical operations. So in modern computers can perform generic set of operations known as programs. Means, so whatever task we have written, that is called as a program, and program is executed. Once the program executes, so we get a different kinds of output and computer will perform different ranges of tasks. That is computer. So then what is computer graphics? Computer graphics is deals with generating images with the aid of computer, or else I can say the images which are generated using computer, with the help of computer, is called as a computer graphics. Maybe you can imitate your house, you can imitate yourself, or you can imitate a vehicle. Using computer, if you can generate the same object through computer, then I can say that image is called as a computer graphics. So computer graphics deals with generating images with the help of computer. In today's computer graphics, is a core technology in digital photography, film making and games, cell phones, computer display and many more specializations, right? So we cannot live without a computer nowadays, computer and mobile. And we know that earlier days, if you go back to 10 decades or 20 decades back, so the computers will be having only processing part and memory part. But nowadays, having a graphics part is also a very essential part. If you consider a smartphone, your smartphone will be having a 500 MB or 1 GB of graphic card also, right? So to process the graphical data, because nowadays people are consuming more images, more videos. So they are consuming images and videos through social medias. So your mobile phones should be able to process all such data. To process only the graphical part, you need a separate processor for graphics, right? So this is the importance of graphics. We cannot live without a graphics or without the images or videos. So they are the part of our life. For there are different purposes, we will see later. Again, I got one more definition from one more website. Computer graphics is a subfield of computer science. It's a subfield of computer science which studies methods for digitally synthesizing and manipulating visual content. So, synth- synthesizing and manipulating a visual content. So although the term refers to study of three-dimensional computer graphics, when I say computer graphics, we always think about 3D, like 3D movies or 3D animation. But not only 3D is not only called as computer graphics, even 2D is also called as computer graphics. Whatever images we generated using computer are called as computer graphics. That is computer graphics, the last word, visualization. So visualization is any technique for creating images, diagrams, animations, and they are created to communicate some message. Visualization means creation of images, some graphs, some diagrams, some charts, some animations, and they are created for the purpose of communicating some message. For example, now we are suffering from a pandemic time. So for example, I wanted to know what is the visualization of COVID statistics. If you go and search in Google, so you get so many images of visualization of COVID statistics, right? COVID-19 statistics. So that can be called as visualization. That can be data visualization. So visualization is nothing but a representation of object, situation, or set of information in the form of chart and diagram. That is called as visualization. So now we got to know what is the meaning of computer graphics and visualization. We have a computer, we generate images using computer, that is called as computer graphics, and I communicate that generated image through some media, that is called as computer graphics and visualization. So this is some introduction to the subject. Okay, now we will understand course outcomes of this subject. So we have promised 5 course outcomes to the students. So first outcome, apply the concept of graphics pipeline with appropriate techniques. That is our first outcome. Apply the concept of computer graphics pipeline with appropriate techniques. So from this, after learning the subject, students will be able to apply the concept of graphics pipeline. We have a concept called graphic pipeline. The students will be able to apply those techniques. Second outcome, apply mathematical and logic to perform elementary computer graphics operation. So again, second outcome says students will be able to apply mathematical and logical operations to perform elementary computer graphics operation. That is the second outcome. So third outcome says analyze the suitability of OpenGL API to illustrate geometric operation. So students will be able to analyze what kind of OpenGL API they should use to illustrate computer graphics operation. That is the third outcome. Fourth outcome, implement strategic approach to solve problems in the domain of computer graphics using OpenGL. So that is the fourth outcome. So fifth outcome, evaluate the appropriate computer graphics models and algorithms. So finally, students will be able to evaluate appropriate computer graphics and models and algorithms. So these are the 5 outcomes. So I can say students will be able to apply computer graphics pipeline, computer graphics, some mathematical logic, some elementary, they can generate some elementary graphics, they can analyze what is the problem, and they can choose what graphic API they should use, and they can implement and they can generate computer graphics elements. Either they can use 2D or 3D, they can transform, they can rotate, they can translate the computer graphics elements. Finally, they can evaluate different algorithms, different models. This is about course outcomes. So we are promising. Next we have, what are the objective of this course, computer graphics and visualization? So why you should study this subject? So for example, if you have any task, you have purpose for that. So without the purpose, you won't do anything. In the same way, why you should learn this subject? So you should learn this subject because you can go through the concept of hardware and software and OpenGL graphics elements. So from this subject you will be knowing what are the hardware components involved, what is the software component involved, and what is the OpenGL concept involved to generate computer graphics elements and illustrate interactive computer graphics using OpenGL. So from this subject you can illustrate, you can demonstrate computer graphics using OpenGL. So you will be learning one more library called Open Graphics Library. Through that you can illustrate computer graphics elements. Next, one more objective: design implement of algorithms for 2D graphics primitives and objects. That is a objective, one more objective. One more, fourth one: demonstrate geometric transformation weaving on both 2D and 3D. There is a one more objective. From this you will be learning, you are able to demonstrate geometric transformations weaving in 2D and 3D. Final objective: infer the representation of curves, surfaces, colors and illumination models. So after learning this subject, so you will be able to represent curves, surfaces, colors and illumination models. So these are the objectives of this course. This course is made up of 5 modules. In module 1 we will be learning introduction to the computer graphics, applications of computer graphics. We will be learning what is OpenGL. This is a new library to you, so you will be understanding what is OpenGL, different data types, then different graphic objects like points, lines, polygons, then size, color, different attributes like size, color, length and different functions. So for example, if you want to draw a line, how do you write? We have function for that. How to set a color, how to set vertex, we call vertex as a point. So all the basic things we will be learning in the first module. So in second module you will be learning 2D geometric transformation and 2D weaving. So we have different transformation functions, so you will be learning those things, 2D. In third module you will be learning 3D transformations as well as clipping. And in the fourth module you will be learning 3D weaving as well as visible surface detection, some algorithms, some 3D weaving concepts. And in the finally fifth module you will be learning how to interact with hardware devices, like how to interact with input devices, mouse or keyboard, how to create menus, how to create animation. So these are the 5 modules. First module introduction, second module a 2D environment and some complex primitives or complex objects of computer graphics. Third module is about 3D transformation. Fourth module is about 3D weaving and 3D clipping of elements. Fifth module is input interaction. So this is the content of whole syllabus. Next we will have first concept: what are the applications of computer graphics? Already I said, so there are so many applications of computer graphics. We cannot assume our life without computer graphics. We are indirectly or directly dependent on computer graphics for different purpose. So I have listed out many applications. The first application says graphics and arts. Computer graphics is used for graphics and arts. Second application, computer aided programming. And third one, virtual reality, there is a fast moving technology. Fourth one, data visualization for the purpose of data visualization. Fifth one, education and training. Sixth one, computer art. Next, entertainment purpose, image processing, graphical user interface. So these are the different areas of computer graphics. So first one we'll go for graphics and charts. So the first application is graphics and charts. So as you can see the picture, so this is very common in the industry. This is very common where you represent all the information in the form of charts. So here you can see there are different types of charts, pie chart, bar chart, or line chart, or area chart. So as I said, so if you want to know what is the current status of COVID, so we can represent that information in different types of charts. That is the one of the application of computer graphics. So this is just an image which is generated using computer. Next application, computer aided design. For example, in the field of mechanics, in the field of civil engineering, they design the elements or they design the machines. So actually before they are actually building them, in the civil engineering also, before actually they are building the buildings, so they will be having the plan. So nowadays it is very common, so you will be having the plan, you will have a graphic animation, you can walk through your house before construction of actual house, you can walk through your house and you can see all the walls, wherever necessary you can make changes. That is the next application. Another application, a upcoming new trend, it is a VR, virtual reality environments. For example, if you want to visit any a place which is outside the India, so you can just have a look through VR, virtual reality. So you can have a goggle, specially designed goggles, you can wear those goggles and you can view the environment. So or else games, a multi-purpose game or interactive games also you can play through VRs. Let us say you are in forest or you are in some battlefield. So whatever, you can change the environment. That is the one of the application of computer graphics. Next application, data visualization. As you can see the picture, so data visualization, you can have a visualization of data. I have put one of the example as a COVID status, COVID number of cases in India. So this is the generated image from the data. So you can observe there are different countries, different states in the India. They are marked with different color. So based on the range, we can use graphics to teach students in better way. For example, one of the best way is Byju's. So I think you will be knowing the Byju's company. They are teaching students with more graphical elements. For example, if the student wanted to know about solar system, they can just have a look of animation of solar system, or they can wear a VR goggle, or they can have a beautiful animation system. Correct. So that is where it is very useful. The same way training, when I say training, so let us say if you want to drive a car, you can just have a simulation version of a car, just animated version of a car. It is also for training. The same way computer art, for example Photoshop or some graphical tools to generate computer graphics, even that is the application of computer graphics. Finally, entertainment, it is not less. There are humorous or huge number of applications in entertainment. For example, TV, mobile, computer, movies, some web series, everywhere we see computer graphics. So I have put one of the famous film, or two to three famous film, Avatar and Jurassic Park and Bahubali, and some gaming applications where we use computer graphics to generate images which is just equal to a reality. I think you have felt it in the one of the movie called Bahubali. We feel that it is a real world, but actually it is not a real world. So they have acted in front of the green background. So after making, they have edited, they have created a computer graphics. So, and one more application is image processing. So image processing is in the field of medical. So I can say X-ray or CT scan, even they are the images generated from computer. Correct? So this is one of the major application where we use computer graphics, that is the medical field. So you can easily analyze what is the patient current status through his X-rays, CT scan or other type of images. So finally, graphical user interface. I think you have experienced it. If you are using a latest mobile, a smartphone and if you have used a mobile 10 years before or 5 years before, just 5 years before, the mobiles were not user friendly. They are not very interactive. But nowadays, your mobile phones are very user friendly. You can, or any elder person, any person without any technical knowledge, he can operate any mobile or tablet or PC, right? So because of a user friendliness. So that is the one of the major application of computer graphics. So there are many applications of computer graphics. As I said, you can use computer graphics to generate charts, visualize the data, education purpose, computer art, mainly entertainment purpose. In entertainment, computer graphics is the one of the biggest field, and image processing for medical or image processing for education. So, and graphical user interface. So these are the applications of computer graphics. Thank you. We'll continue in the next session.